Welcome everyone, and here we are in the last part of this module four, and we are going to conclude our course of introduction to business management. I hope you have enjoyed my recording and also live lectures and the tutorials we have delivered as a team at Swahar University. So let's conclude this, and I hope this course will provide you the foundation for the other courses, and also with those case studies, short case studies and interactive videos in the tutorials will help you to apply your concepts in the daily life in the Omani organizations. So let's conclude this last module with the change management. Recently, due to Corona and cyclone, you see the change happened, and this change has demanded us to deliver these lectures online and record them. So this is one sort of change we are talking about. Sometimes we change the top management, the CEO, then they bring new culture. This is another type of change. Similarly, if you were at the store of Lulu, you were purchasing grocery while visiting them. Now this is a change. Because of this change, you can now order those grocery online. So this is another type of change. So this change you have to manage. And if this change is planned and sometimes not planned properly, if you have some plan A, plan B or backup plans, then you will survive. Otherwise, you can see most of the hotels, small shops and the businesses have closed during Corona because they were unable to survive during the change process. So larger organization definitely understand this change process, and we will try to understand this change process during this slide. So a change is the act of act or process through which something becomes different. As we have given you example of the Corona, the online classes, the online grocery store, and everything is coming online. This is sort of change. So managing change means working closely with the employee and setting clear goals about how the change will be managed. So if some change is happening, like we are trying and we have learned a lot during this Corona, that how to deliver online classes, and how you have also learned how to take classes online, how to order pizza online already, or grocery online, or anything. So these are the things you have learned. But within the organization, everyone should learn this change. Organizational change refers to the action in which a company or business alter a major component of its technology or infrastructure. Which technology we have changed? We were delivering our lectures offline. Now we are delivering it online. That is the major shift or change in our technology or infrastructure. So if you try to follow this process of change, then this is a three-step process, which is unfreezing, changing, and refreezing. So if you see, initially you were in the rigid shape, you try to unfreeze it. That means, like, if you see it like an ice cube, you melt it down and ultimately you make a change in that ice cube, and finally the circle will come over here. So this is an example of sort of change, not exactly this type of change we are talking about. We are talking about the organizational change, definitely. So organizational change is actually, we are talking about any alterations in the people structure or technology. So I have given you the example of technology. Like, we have changed from simple phone you used to, your father may have a small phone where there is no Wi-Fi, there is no internet, that you cannot talk a video call. This is a technological change you can observe. But if you go for the structure or people change, initially it was just one boss, everyone was going for the leave to that boss. But once the organization is big, then you create the top management, middle management, and first line manager, and you then in that organization, you can apply for your leave for immediate line manager, need not to go to CEO directly. So this is the change in the structure and people. So then it is the change in a person who actually pushes the change is called the change agent. And types of change are, for example, change agents are actually these managers, non-managers, and sometime outside, like this Corona is the externally it is coming. But if a new manager is coming, IT manager, and he is trying to develop the online SULMS or web sites with you, then this is an internal type of change you are actually accepting. So this these are a few examples for structural change, where specialization, technology, work processes and methods you improve, the people attitudes you change, your perception you can change, your behavior you can change, and this is we will discuss more about these changes in our next class. So now if you go for this last slide, this is about this managing resistance to change. I mean, you feel you will find resistance. For example, if some really old man or old guy who is 60 or 59 year old and he is going to retire, then he may not accept to adopt for the SULMS or MIS system or mobile apps to help the customers. So that is one sort of resistance to change. So we have some really important type of resistance. For example, education and communication we can do to train our staff, but depending on the age, some people are willing to learn, some people are not willing to learn. You cannot maybe changing them, you may be giving them other operations. So it education and communication, however, can help you. Yes, this is a coronavirus, you have to talk online, you have to take classes online, and you have to give orders online, stay away from each other, keep a proper distance. So this is the education the government has given to you, and we can generate the same education and message over here in the Swar University. Then there are participations. If you go for the participation, they allows those who oppose a change to participate in the decision. If you listen to them, then this participation will help to reduce their resistance, and you will be able to manage the change successfully. Then facilitation and support, provide support efforts such as employee counseling, therapies, and new trainings and skills you impart them. So it, by this, your resistance to change will come little down. Then you have a manipulation and co-optations are there. Manipulation is actually help you to resist this change, and co-option is the form of the manipulation and participation, and we will discuss more about this in the class. Selecting people who accept the change means you actually, if somebody is willing to deliver lecture online or willing to use the app online to deliver your order for pizza, then you take those people and present them as a model. Look, these people are actually helping. So that is all for this lecture. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.